Mr. Bhaskar Chakravarti, former Vice President, Micro Labs India Limited. I'm sure many people may have already heard him on the TED Talk. Mr. Bhaskar Chakravarti is a pharma veteran, having worked for 38 years in leadership positions in sales and marketing, both in India and abroad. He has switched to academics as faculty in marketing and management and digital entrepreneurship. He has held several top leadership positions in companies such as Pfizer, Cipla, Park Davis, IPCA, Microlabs, and has built successful teams, brands, and business relationships. He has published a paper, Digital Business in Healthcare, Will It Survive or Succumb? So I think, you know, as we go ahead and discuss a lot on technology, how technology adaptations is happening to marketing in the pharmaceutical sector or otherwise, I think, you know, he'll be really highlighting on that. Looking at his educational background, he has BSc Physiology from Presidency College, Extension Program in Marketing Management from IIM Kolkata, and MBA from IISWBM Kolkata. Thank you, Mr. Bhaskar. Welcome to the webinar. So moving on, so we had a glimpse about the drug and the technologies and then devices and then how, you know, the disruptive technologies or the latest technologies are entering into all aspects of the pharmaceutical from manufacturing to the patient level. And moving over to your expertise area, sir, now on to Mr. Bhaskar, looking at, you know, there is a lot of the technologies are being extensively used in marketing. And so, and then, you know, I'm sure these large ones, large companies are poised for it. You know, they have the ability, they have the money, they have the know-how or technology itself for marketing. But maybe if we really look at the larger spectrum of the companies, we also understand is a kind of like in healthcare, it's many of them are smaller companies. So the question to you would be, you know, how is it that technology is helping the pharmaceutical industry in marketing? But, you know, what is it that it can really do, or is it already there in the smaller companies, and how do we really look at the spectrum? Yeah, you want to unmute your mic, sir?
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Usha. It's really a pleasure to be with all of you, all my co-panelists. Well, I have a different journey in the pharmaceutical industry. You know, started carrying the bag and reaching to the doctors and sharing information from whatever the back end has provided me. So technology, if you really ask me, I like to go back earlier days, say maybe 32 years ago, I was in one of the top five companies, and I was given a very unique job title of executive field operations. That was unique in the industry. And you know what was the job? The job was I was working with the EDP. Those days it was called EDP, electronic data processing, not IT these days. So EDP and myself, we programmed a field activity analysis so that once we enter all the data from the field reports from, now in marketing, I'm talking about our front runners, medical representatives. There are more than 6 lakhs of them in India, right? So they are the marketing people, actually. So we were analyzing their activities through this program. And I must, that was 32 years ago and must be based on basic programming language. And we used to enter the daily reports and take out printouts of the analysis of how many doctors is visited, what is the daily call average, and what is the personal order booking from pharmacist, and what are the samples that he has given, and things like that. You know, that was my first experience of technology in marketing. And then we used to do some forecasting based on, I don't know whether anyone's heard of it, but this was Lotus 1-2-3. There was no Microsoft then. So that was the beginning of technology in marketing. And then, of course, Excel came in. And let me tell you, I'm talking about these programs because they help marketing people in many ways, you know. But these are the technologies for forecasting. And Excel, by the way, is such a versatile program that it's not really discovered. There are so many features and benefits from Excel itself. And then came last 20 years, this or maybe 15 years, this concept of CRM, customer relationship management. And that was essentially technology. So based on key account management of key opinion leaders. But I guess, you know, there is, with farmer marketing people, there is some technophobia where we are very slow in adapting technology. So CRM is still in practice. At least I know that the top 20 companies, they have a CRM in place. But I have mixed opinions about the outcome of CRM because I don't know whether the leadership of some of the companies have also accepted it, because they're thinking in terms of return on the CRM technology investment, whether it was worth it. So, and the focus was more on technology, but actually the purpose was different. The focus should be on customers. So with this, now my story is from Mirage 2000 to Rafale. So now coming to Rafale, I must tell you that today we are now embarking on a situation, especially because of COVID, that we are now thinking and talking and implementing in terms of AI, ML, data analytics, maybe Java or R. Now, these are the things that pharma marketing. Now, every pharma marketing company, the top 20, they have a technical officer. They have a digital manager. So there is technology picking up in all pharma companies where, you know, Python-based algorithms are being worked out. Which recognizes voice, text, pictures. So all these machine learning applications are being worked out. Today, I know that there are at least 6 agencies in India, and I'm sure these number of agencies will keep increasing because the number of pharmaceutical companies are much more, that they are now trying to bring the pharma companies to a digital platform, which is only meant for physicians, meant for doctors. And it's like the telemedicine platforms, because they have found that, especially in the last 3-4 months, there has been a 500% growth in e-consultation, telemedicine. Okay. Now, pharma company marketing, we want to meet the doctors wherever they are. And today, if it is not in the clinic, then we want to meet them at their digital platforms where they visit with their peers, their colleagues. They learn and they want to, they have some requirements, telemedicine. Okay. Now, pharma company marketing, we want to meet the doctors wherever they are. And today, if it is not in the clinic, then we want to meet them at their digital platforms where they visit, where it's like their digital club, where they interact, exchange with their peers, their colleagues, they learn, and they want to, they have some requirements. So pharma companies are now thinking of putting a chatbot there so that there is some inbound traffic to them. so that they can work their outbound activities. Now, you asked me one question, whether the smaller companies can afford it. Now, let me tell you, being in Bangalore, I know that there are many startup companies who are working on these tech solutions. Now, startup companies may be affordable for smaller companies. So this is, the trend that I see in terms of technology. But then I would like to add a few more points here that, again, I go back to my Mirage days that, you know, we used to have experts discussion, panel discussions on the television, national networks. And say on once a week, national network experts from various zones of the country used to come and discuss on malaria management, treatment. Today, it's still happening, you know, because of COVID. There are discussions on by endocrinologists and diabetologists and cardiologists talking to the mass, the viewers of television about how to take care because they are vulnerable in the COVID environment. So that medium, well, that is technology, still being used. I also remember that 20 years back, we had, a video of surgeries, new surgeries in India, video of how an orthopedic surgeon had written a script about a dentist who suffers from backache as an occupational hazard. So that video was distributed in a package that was VHS cassette. So good branding to all the dentists. That was marketing, a different medium. But today, we have come to the digital space, the website, and the social media marketing. I know some of the top 10 pharmaceutical companies are very active in the social media. There is a company in the top 5 who has produced 75 videos in the last maybe 6-7 years. And most of the videos are on consumer health products. And that is another thing. Some of the products that we promoted and detailed to the doctors 30 years back, they are now available on e-commerce. That's the index of popularity and safety that direct to consumers on e-commerce. So these companies and most of the big companies, they have consumer health products vertical. So they're using social media. And once they use social media, there are experts who do the analytics in terms of click-through rates and impressions and, you know, the impressions and clicks and likes and comments and shares. These are the metrics today. Right. So, and then I also remember one anecdote that there was a dentist who left dentistry practice and started making animations for patients on patient education. You know, this is going to be what root canal treatment is going to be like, what implant is going to be like through animated digital versions. But today we have virtual reality headsets which take the patient to the operation theater and experiences the procedure. So that is the transformation. So, there are others also. Like for example, now recently we've heard of QR code in all the packs. Now the QR code is Internet of Things. It's going to take the consumers directly to the company through the website and interact with the company. So there are startup tech companies who I'm sure will be affordable by the smaller pharma companies.
So as we move ahead, that was one of the most interesting, you know, putting the whole perspective in the technology space, marketing, but also other parts of education and so on. from EDP, you know, or Lotus 1-2-3 to today's virtual reality and CRM and, you know, a whole range of technologies that you said, which can be used for marketing. Hey, sir, over to you. You did say virtual reality already a little bit. So how was that, you know, all the things, IoT or AR, you know, AL, machine learning, you know, so much, you know, the names and the titles are thrown. And yes, we do take it up with a little bit of that pinch of salt that the technologies are already there. But, you know, we have to kind of see what solutions it will provide to the problems that, you know, people face, whether it is a, you know, simple, you know, field person in marketing or now sitting at home, how we can do it, you know. So those are the ones. Very quick thoughts on that, sir.
Yeah. See, I, as a marketing person, I need to serve my customers, offer them a value, a solution. So I have to reach out to my customers wherever they are. Today, there is a survey which says that 89% of the doctors are tech savvy and they are on the net, right? So I will meet them. I mean, as a marketing person, I will have strategies, digital marketing strategies to meet my doctors on the net. As I said, in the e-health platforms, which is only meant for physicians. So I will find out through my AI ML algorithms what they need from me, because I have an interactive channel on these e-platforms. But on the other hand, we also, a survey came to me just yesterday, which says that 72% of the doctors, they don't mind once the COVID is over to meet the medical reps at least once a month, because they feel that when I see the medical rep, I don't need to talk, but I am reminded of the brand of the product. So I will in my strategy, I will make my medical representatives tech savvy so that once they meet personally, once they meet the customers personally, say once a month, they don't waste time and make maximum use of those 2-3 minutes which he or she gets with the customer. So tech-savvy field force, digital marketing on the e-health platforms. And of course, they are all based on your AI, ML, deep learning, predictive analysis. Yes, predictive analysis is something else which I need to predict, forecast. So these are the technologies that we would look forward to.
Wow, I already have a marketing class ready. So, you know, in terms of really looking at, you know, having marketing people who are tech savvy, but at the same time, who would touch base, who would give that personal discipline. So coming towards, I mean, this has been a wonderful discussion. Like I said, we could go on, but the time we have already exceeded. So I will have a rapid round very quickly. But now we talk so much about the technologies for you know, pharma itself, medical device, you know, marketing or the business angle to it, you know, what kinds of things that are, you know, whether it is from supply chain to actual manufacturing, a whole lot of things that we really understood in terms of the kit up with a little bit of that pinch of salt that the technologies are already there, but, you know, we have to kind of see what solutions it will provide to the problems that you know, people face, whether it is a, you know, simple, you know, field person in marketing or now sitting at home, how we can do it, you know. So those are the ones. Very quick thoughts on that, sir.
Yeah. See, I, as a marketing person, I need to serve my customers, offer them a value, a solution. So I have to reach out to my customers wherever they are. Today, there is a survey which says that 89% of the doctors are tech savvy and they are on the net, right? So I will meet them. As a marketing person, I will have strategies, digital marketing strategies to meet my doctors on the net. As I said, in the e-health platforms, which is only meant for physicians. So I will find out through my AI ML algorithms what they need from me, because I have an interactive channel on these e-platforms. But on the other hand, we also a survey came to me just yesterday, which says that 72% of the doctors, they don't mind once the COVID is over to meet the medical reps at least once a month, because they feel that when I see the medical rep, I don't need to talk, but I am reminded of the brand of the product. So I will in my strategy, I will make my medical representatives tech savvy, so that once they meet personally, once they meet the customers personally, say once a month, they don't waste time and make maximum use of those 2-3 minutes which he or she gets with the customer. So tech savvy field force, digital marketing on the e-health platforms. And of course, they are all based on your AI, ML, deep learning, predictive analysis. Yes, predictive analysis is something else which I need to predict, forecast. So these are the technologies that we would look forward to.
So from fundamentals to this, to a final, say on, because marketing is a very important part of really bringing awareness about the product to across different stakeholders in the pharma or, whichever sector, in fact. So, so therefore, over to you, sir, for, top 5 marketing skills, pharmaceutical sector.
Okay. The topmost that I value is empathy. Empathy. Does a person, marketing person, know how to empathize with the customers? I'll give you an example. The other day, I found a TV reporter, a news channel reporter, wearing the PPE kit and going to a COVID area. And he said that I am really surprised, amazed how these health workers are wearing this PPE kit for 12 hours, 8 to 12 hours, and it's so hot inside and they can't go to the washroom. And that is empathy. That is what the news reporter empathized. And then the next day, in fact, it's today, I saw, I think it was a doctor who's devised a bubble. You all must have seen it on TV today, a bubble which injects purified air. And so the health worker doesn't, the HCP doesn't wear a kit, only a bubble around the head, and getting purified air and performing his duty. So that is empathy. So whether a person can really relate in terms of examples that he has experienced in life about empathy, the rest are in place. Service attitude, communication. Now, even both verbal and written is important, because today we are talking about content writing. So that is writing communication skill. And then, of course, a marketing person has to be creative. And today, because of the digital era, you have to have some analytical skills, digital analytical skills. And lastly, stress management skills, whether the person can manage stress, because the pressure and the stress is going to keep increasing for all of us. But empathy on top.